Okay, so firstly, ella Malayali comrades enum namaskara. Wait, I have one more line. Check. Valare adhiga santosham undu neengale kaanam. My cinematographer, my editor, they are Malayalis. They have even shot my other one more film of mine, which was really successful, called Taxi Wala. Sujit Sarang and Srijit Sarang, they're not here. I was hoping, I was telling them, my whole, whenever I'm in Kerala, please be there. You have to do a lot of speaking, but both of them are busy in the post-production. But I'm really happy to be here. We shot in Kerala for this film. For about 10 days, we shot in Kerala, and I really enjoyed it, and the people are super warm, and I just, I get down the flight from the airport only, I see all really smiling, happy, warm faces always, and I really like my Malayali comrades, so I'm very happy to be here. Rashmika.
Ellarku swagatham. Thank you for coming. It's actually my first time in Kochi. Actually, we landed here for our shoot, no? We landed here and we went to?
Huh? Vagamond.
Ah, Vagamond. So, yeah, I'm from Coorg, so we are in the borderline of Kerala, and it's, I have a lot of Malayali neighbors, and I really love them, so it's so nice to be here. It feels extremely special, and yeah, somehow all of them have such smiling faces. I like people who smile. I like people who are happy human beings, so all of you are much, much lighter and so much more livelier, so yeah, it makes me really happy to be here. And okay, why? Now everyone are serious.
No, we shot here for 10 days, and by the end of the 10 days, when we went back to Hyderabad also, all my team, my staff, everyone is calling each other, Cheta, 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 Cheta. And I think one thing is the language.
It's so small.
Why everyone, they hear Telugu songs, and everyone comes and checks the Malayali version of the songs, because the language has some beauty to it. So we'll be in the car traveling, and my cameraman Sujit got married very recently. He'll be talking to his wife. Like, enda ki undu vishesha? Something he'll be talking. I won't understand what's happening, but I'll just be like, I'll be listening. And I'm like, it sounds nice, you talk. It sounds really nice, whatever you're talking. So it's a lovely language. So we'll take some questions.
Anybody from the audience, questions? Shoot your questions.
Yes, ma'am.
What kind of films would you like? Is it content-driven films or commercial films?
I think commercial films can also be content-driven. I think content... I don't know these categories as well, because what I try to do is the films, the content I like, we try and make it commercially viable. Like, this is like a very strong story. This is we are talking about fighting for what we love, and but we try to tell it in, like, I think it will work commercially as well. I don't know. When I listen to something, I really like it, and I can see it play out, and I do it. There's not so much calculation to it. You really need to like and enjoy and feel happy with what you're doing. So I guess that's how I pick my cinema.
Next.
I would also like to, one main reason for coming here today is we launched the Dear Comrade Music Festival. I know the word comrade is very popular here in Kerala. But the word comrade essentially means, what it means is, you know, someone who is there with you through your good times and bad times, who's always there as a support, who's always there with you through your success, failure, and is always like a support system. That's what comrade means, and that's what is a comrade in our film. He's someone who will fight for you, fight with you on your goals. And so when we decided it was time for release, we decided that I feel like if I've come so far, if all of you are coming to see me and interview me and people are watching my films, I do Telugu films and you watch it here, be it Geeta Govindam or Arjun Reddy, which didn't even get like a mainstream release, but still so many people, so many of you managed to watch it. I feel like you've been part of this journey of mine, from being no one who, like, none of you knew till all of you love. And people across the four states have given so much love, and we decided that we want to celebrate it with you. You're also my comrades. You have also been a support. So we decided to make this really fun, and we launched the Dear Comrade Music Festival yesterday. The first show was in Bangalore yesterday, last night, and it was a massive, super fun show. It went super well. And then tonight we are going to do one more big show here in Kochi, and that's the main reason for coming here today. It'll be today. We start from 7 o'clock and it'll go on till around 9:30, 10 in the Gokulam Convention Center. And I know you all are film journalists and press, and every day you cover film interviews, film promotions, and it gets boring. So I think if you have time this evening, you all should just come and just have some fun. If we can arrange for that, I think you come, you'll have like a good show. It's like you're kind of doing work, but you're not working because it's full on entertainment. So I think you guys should take that break and come and have some fun this evening. It'll be mad.
Come party with us. We invite all of you closely, personally. Also, I was just looking at the trailer and I was just telling Vijay and sir that it looks like a Malayalam film itself.
Yeah, to me it feels like a straight Malayalam film. I think I need to thank E4 Entertainment for such an amazing job on the dubbing. Like the voices,
very well
E4, done. Like you did it superbly, man, I think. It's done really well. Like I forgot that it is a Telugu film. I was just watching it. Like, yeah. Done really well.
Vijay sir.
Yes.
You started from dramas. How was the journey from drama to movies?
It's like any journey, man. It's like sometimes it's hard to start. You need to kickstart it, you need to push start it, and then there are lots of speed breakers. Then you hit some roads where you can drive really fast, and I like driving fast. So it's been a hard journey to start. Like, to start off was the hardest thing, but once I found that road, now I'm like going like full power. So it's taught me a lot, doing theater. Then trying to break into cinema, playing minor roles, then not having work for a long time. And then I did a film called Yevide Subramanyam, which I thought was my big break, where I played a supporting role, which was well received. Film did really well, but then again, I didn't have any work for 1.5 years. And then Pelli Chupulu happened, and then since then, I haven't stopped. I haven't like taken a break. Like, I've been working non-stop. So it's been a journey, and it's gone like really quick. Like when I look back, sometimes it's scary, like how fast things have moved.
They all have very deep questions for you, for sure.
Hi Vijay.
Hey. Hi brother.
It's a simple question. Out of curiosity, I'm asking: can we expect you in a Malayalam movie?
I've always wanted my film to be seen by people across regions. One way to do it is to do a Telugu film, to do a Tamil. I did a Tamil film called Nota, to do a Malayalam film, to do a Kannada film. But when I did my Tamil film, I know zero Tamil, absolutely nothing. I had to learn it all. It was really hard for me to act. I shouldn't be thinking. I should only be reacting to the person. So if I have to think of the words, I don't enjoy it. So the only thing that's stopping me from doing it is my lack of command over the language. If I can manage to learn that, and people have advised me to get a Malayali girlfriend to learn the language. I don't know if it's advisable. Malayali women are super pretty, but I don't think I should be using those shortcuts to learn a language. But if I could learn the language, it would be amazing. Why we put this effort of doing a parallel release in all these languages is this is another way I can... when I used to watch cinema, when I was a college kid, I used to watch I used to watch Malayalam films, I watched with subtitles because they weren't getting dubbed as much. I had to find it with subtitles. Tamil films would get dubbed into Telugu, and I would prefer to watch the dubbed version to the subtitle version so that I don't have to look down, so that I can see the actors. And I really enjoyed, and I would watch it like my own film. I didn't know this is dubbed, this is that. You'd get so involved in the film. So I realized one way of doing it is, of course, people have been watching it with subtitles. Some people prefer it that way. But I was like, there would be so many people like me who want to watch it in their own language and not think about trying to read something. So we got it dubbed, but we will also release the subtitled version as well. We'll release the Tamil version, subtitle version, and the Malayalam version. It took... this is the only film after... KGF to do all the four languages, and this is the first time we are attempting it from Telugu. Bahubali has done it, except in Kannada, they didn't. We are doing it, and it's new, so we are figuring out how all this works, and it's like extreme loads of work, but I think it'll be worth it. Post it. It'll be nice if even 10 more people watch it and enjoy it. It's completely worth the effort. So hopefully if I learn the language, I will, I'm like meeting lots of Malayalam directors and stuff who come and tell stories, so we'll see. Same question. Yeah, she was ready, she was telling me.
Yes, I want to.
No,
I like going across, I like getting involved in their culture, in their languages. When I started doing Telugu films, I had no idea, not even a word, meaning of a word. But it's like when I know that I'm going to work there, that's when I learn the language. Otherwise, I'm like, meaning that's when I start working towards it. Otherwise, I'm like, okay, fine. So yes, you'll see me in Malayalam film, but if there's anyone agreeing to get me on board.
Also, it's easier because when you're kids, you can pick up language quicker. I'm too old to learn languages, whereas for her, she's still like a kid, so she picks up languages like quickly.
Thanks.
Yeah, no, how else do you explain?
No, it's not like
this. Okay, ma'am, share some, what about your characters in Dear Comrade, both of your characters, some introduction about...
Bobby, Lily.
How do you feel that character? So, yeah.
Basically, I think Lily is... You all have a Lily in your lives. You all have a Lily in your, you know, hearts. You all have a Lily in your homes. And Bobby, will they have Bobbies in your colleges probably? You'll have a Bobby in your college.
So I play a character called Bobby who's like... any student, you know, every college, every campus will have some students who are into student politics, who are a little aggressive, who want to do strikes, call off exams, have holiday, call buns. So he's one such character who's a little aggressive, short-tempered thing. But the thing is, his intentions are right. He believes, like if he believes in something, he wants to fight for it. And she plays this girl who comes into her life, you know, like she's his neighbor. One day she comes into his life and she's beautiful, so of course he has a crush on her. But she plays a cricketer. She plays a girl called Lily who plays state cricket, and she's quite in contrast to him. And the rest,
she's,
I think,
determined, you know, in what she wants to do, and she's understanding. She is. She's just.
But
like,
I don't know, like, the point of describing our characters.
Yeah.
Why, I don't know what this achieves. Does it make it more interesting for you to watch the film if I describe the character, or it'll fill 100 words in the article? It'll make your article writing easier. Because I find it quite boring to describe a character, like,
and you don't
he
know
is
how
a
to.
Student leader, he is aggressive. I think that should come across through the trailer. When he's slapping someone, he is aggressive. She's playing how they're
she's
behaving.
Just,
I think it should
yeah.
come across. I don't think I should explain this because it's boring. When I'm explaining, I'm like, dude, I don't want to watch this film.
But then think about it. Other than this, what about the film?
Yeah, it's hard to talk about it because
yeah.
we don't want to. There's some crucial plot points which we couldn't reveal in the trailer. And it was very hard to cut the trailer because we wanted to communicate the story as it is, yet not give away some
anything.
Like a crucial plot point. So it took, like, I didn't sleep for 3-4 days while this was happening. But then we managed, and the trailer is like a rage right now, and we're really happy that all the songs, the trailer, everything's working the way it is.
Vijay, have you been ever into student politics, or do you met any real life comrades in your life?
He was apparently boring.
No, man, like I said, in a hostel first till 10th, and it was like a Gurukulam. It was like the spiritual place kind of thing. Then in my intermediate, I came to Hyderabad, and there I saw this concept of student unions. Till then, I didn't even know this existed. I saw it, but I was never a part of it. I was just fascinated by these guys who would do all these things. And they all would be so proud. They would feel like they had a purpose and stuff. So I've seen it, but I've never been a part of any student unions. So here also, is it the same concept of we do the print media first and then television next? Is that the concept here? Because that was everybody here, huh? At one time. Okay, sweet.
Cool.
Hi, Vijay.
Yes.
What's the surprise for DQ? Yesterday you tweet about mentioning Kunjika, you tweet about a surprise.
Yeah,
is
there's
there
a reason I called it surprise, no? Not to tell you in a press meet. I don't want to kill the surprise.
Can we get a clue? Is there any about any film or anything?
You'll see in the next 10 days, I want to reveal the surprise. But Dulkar has been a brother, man. Like, he's one sweetheart to the max. Like, I don't even know what, like, why is this man so sweet? I was in France shooting, and then I just call him and I'm like, Dulkar. And we just, and me and Dulkar, of course, we did Mahanati, where we met briefly. When I was shooting for Nota in Chennai, he was shooting in Chennai, so we used to meet then. But he's just been, and I was in France and I was talking to him, I needed him to do something. He'd be like, you shoot, you chill, it's okay, I'll handle things here. And then he would just do these things. I didn't even see him, I didn't even meet him, I couldn't even say thanks. We have something that I think everyone here and everyone in Telugu and everyone, Dulkar's fans in the north, I think they're all going to completely love something. But whatever is coming is full on fire. I think it's like hot, it's like heat, full heat. I was a Dulkar fan, like, before I became an actor. Like, most of the Malayalam films I watched were his. His were the films I would watch with subtitles. So I think I've watched almost all his films. And then I became an actor, and suddenly we were acting together and all. And then suddenly we were like, bro. And like, dude, I used to watch you on a laptop with subtitles. So it's really cool.
You know, both of you have similar vibes to each other. Like, I find you like brothers.
Yeah, we are just chill people.
Acha, so yeah. That's the vibe. Cool.
Hi, ma'am. Hi, sir. My question is to you. This is the second movie with Vijay sir. How do you feel about it? What was the experience?
How should I feel about it?
Amazing.
Really? Oh my God. Okay. Amazing.
It's the best experience in your life.
Life-changing experience. No, you don't get that. No. It's of course been amazing. No. It's been okay. It's been okay. Like, your experience should be amazing. I'm such a nice person to you.
No. I'm really glad you did Geeta Govindam and you became Lily. I'm very happy you played.
Really happy.
Yeah, you did.
So you're satisfied that I played the character, but you're not happy, like, you're not...
What is this? Why are we having one?
Okay. Of course, I mean, getting to work with him for two films has changed the way I think about films. I see how he works and I'm like, it is inspiring. They take it too over the head. Do you? Don't you? He didn't listen to it good. Okay. Let me just go from there.
Okay.
But it's been amazing. Of course, it's been amazing. And I wish to work with him. Hey, give me a chance, no? In one of your next films as well. I'm serious.
When you finish your circle of all the stars of South and Tamil
Vijay
and everything.
Gets dates.
Okay, sweet.
Yeah, but this is how it is. It's special. So I'm really glad I got to do two films with him in my growing years.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Are there any more questions? Are we done? Should I do a countdown? Huh? 10, 9, 8, 7. 6. Five. Are you feeling pressure, journalists?
3, 2.5, 2.
Okay, thank you all so much. It was lovely speaking to you.
once again, sir. So, July 26th, Dear Comrade Malayalathil release aavunnathu. Oru theaters undaavum. Ivide irikkunna ellam print, visual, endha paraya online, offline, ellam medias. Orikkal koodi parayukayanu. Need all your support. So they came all the way from Hyderabad in Indala, Bangalore. So they were saying they had a blast yesterday evening. So adu kaiyinjittu vannu namukku vendi Malayalam release na athra importance oda kandu ivada vannadana. So expecting support from all the media people here. So thank you so much for coming to Kerala.
Absolutely.
Sarisa, thank you so much. Sarisa is representing the production team of Dear Comrade.
Sarisa,
thank you so much, sir. Sir, please come to this.
Sarisa is the CEO of...